121 degree heat heads towards Palm Springs, plus daily thunderstorms. Let's break it down in today's daily shower. Thunderstorm chances for today, there's a bullseye around Helena, some south of Santa Fe into the panhandle of Texas, south of Phoenix too. Kind of a little bit of the monsoon there. Highest storm chances are down across the southeast, but there's a swath right in here from Minneapolis down into the Nebraska panhandle and northwestern Kansas. That may become severe. As far as severe weather is concerned, this yellow highlighted area, that's the most likely area for today to have severe thunderstorms. That covers Lubbock up to Guymon, Dodge City, Hayes, Goodland, North Platte, Norfolk, north of Omaha toward Minneapolis, and then going toward the Great Lakes. Of these areas right in here from Minneapolis toward the Sioux is going to have the most likely area for tornadoes today. So sections of Minnesota and Wisconsin with the highest thunderstorm chance to be able to produce tornadoes, as well as some damaging hail throughout that entire yellow area. Here's Tuesday. There's the bullseye shift. It's kind of focusing on Omaha to Sioux City, Yankton, Norfolk, out toward Des Moines. So you have the highest risk of some damaging thunderstorms during the day tomorrow, Tuesday. And then by Wednesday, that bullseye shifts. It's now covering Kansas City, St. Louis, and Des Moines. And within this area, again, that's going to be the highest risk Wednesday for damaging elements like hail, wind, perhaps some isolated tornado. Let's chat about moisture here for a moment. As those thunderstorms cruise down across the Corn Belt into the Midwest and mid-Mississippi, as well as the thunderstorms down here to the southeast, producing quite a bit of rainfall. The bullseye, though, is going to be right in here from Des Moines down towards St. Louis, and some sections here will have more than 3 inches from the thunderstorms, so isolated flooding will be possible there. Let's turn to the heat. I mentioned 121 degree heat is possible in Palm Springs later this week. That excessive heat covers most of the southern tier of states, wrapping up toward Memphis, but all or most all of Texas will be quite hot, southern New Mexico, southern Arizona, into southern Nevada and southern California. Florida will also have some hazardous heat conditions. Out of all the high temperatures for the week, these are the ones that may set or at least threaten record highs. They start in Northern California, cover the South, go out here to the South and East. Even parts of Colorado may have some record heat moving into the southern parts there. Denver may hit at least the chance of 100s into next week. So the outlook is rather hot. And let's touch on that. Significant hazards for next week covers the heat. It builds into Carson City, Salt Lake City, goes down, includes Texas yet again, as well as Florida for the hottest temperatures during the week next week. What is driving this? The atmosphere in May was very much El Nino. It's not at all El Nino in June. And July, it's still kind of confused between what's really going to be the main climate driver, if you will. In previous videos, we talked about the oceans being the driver, and those oceans are creating kind of a persistent high-pressure ridge here up around the Maritimes, Nova Scotia, up to Greenland. That's kind of a blocking pattern that's allowing some unsettled weather for central Canada and the central U.S., our severe weather chances. And we're trying to see that monsoonal high, the ridging down across the south, try to establish itself. But it's this high-pressure area that's trying to move into the southwestern U.S. that is creating the heat. Plus, the unsettled weather is kind of trapped in between. And remember, in previous videos, how the atmosphere acts like pistons on an engine. Where one area goes up, another area comes down, and another piston over here wants to go up. Well, here are your pistons with one in between that's fueling, getting the energy, creating the severe weather. And on either side of that, that's where you have the tranquil, hotter condition. So that's what's driving the atmosphere right now, with the oceans changing very little, without much of a grip of El Nino, if none at all. We're still kind of sit in the stagnant weather pattern, as we've discussed in some of the previous videos. You can check out that latest video based on the July outlook, the summer outlook. What are we looking like as we go throughout the next several months?